Well, I've never been for the federal government being a deadbeat employer. And that's really what happens when, and my friend was one of them that voted, when they voted to say that the government wouldn't provide health care to members of Congress and their staff in the original Obamacare bill. It was kind of stupid to say that. But now it's become a principle that we should all be in Obamacare. It's a failed program, but we should all be in it, including the president and the cabinet. So do I support the idea that we're either all in it or none of it? Of course. I've got to tell you.
So this deal could collapse on that singular issue?
No, I will vote for the deal. But let's understand.
You'll vote for a clean CR.
I'll vote for a clean CR.
But that's not what's up tonight.
But let's understand that the president wants and is happy signed a bill that said members of Congress and their staff would, quote, be in Obamacare. He didn't put himself into it. It's time for him to be in that program along with the vice president and all the thousands of political appointees. Now, having said that, the question of subsidy, and look, I'm a wealthy member of Congress. Let me say something. The American people don't understand that the so-called subsidy is what 2.1 million federal workers and their families, over 8 million people, get. It's no better, no worse. So do I think that the government should strip out the support for these folks and thus be a deadbeat employer? No. But if that's what it takes to get the president's attention, great.
All right.
It's going to have to happen.
Congressman? Well.